companies, Druva and Ola, are planning to go public.
Right.
So, what are the preparations?
I think the first, hurdle Ola has to come over is getting profitable. I think they're almost there. So, hopefully, this will be the year that they will, and then they'll sort of get onto the profitability march. Druva is, of course, will IPO in the US. So, very different area. And I think in the US, profitability is less of a challenge, though it is a profitable company, right? I think there, we want to get to a certain scale before we IPO. I think the commonality in the two incidents is the lack of profitability in the company. So I think not just our portfolio, but I think across portfolios, venture capital investors are seeing this and are telling their companies to focus more on profitability and less on growth, because clearly the public market hasn't respected the growth-only strategy. Certainly, the issue with too much money too soon is that it kicks the ball of product market fit, further down the corridor, right? So I think product market fit, or in de-jargonized language, people loving the product at the right price, right? That can often get kicked down. So we don't know some of these heavily capitalized startups, because they have the discounting strategy. And I know why they have the discounting strategy, is I want to build a customer base, right? But the Achilles heel of that strategy has been is that I may pick up a set of customers that can afford that price, but then cannot afford the right price later on, right? And this happens in a market which has more of a pyramid shape of demographics, like the Indian market, unlike the US, which is more cylindrical in shape. So there I lure you, but then, because the market is pretty even, those customers graduate, right? So I think overcapitalization does create that issue, because I can go with that strategy and I can go with it for very long, right? So it has that issue. We have seen burn-ups because of that. But I think you'll notice that as is in most things, maturity keeps coming in cycles. So I think things are getting better every cycle. There's certainly more maturity now in India than 3-4 years ago.
Definitely.
So I think the SaaS companies certainly have. I think in the consumer companies, we are very close to getting our first set of examples. But I think Ola will be there in 1 or 2 years' time. There are other companies that are outside of our portfolio, so I don't really have details on that. But then I look at PharmEasy within our portfolio. I certainly think they'll be there in 1 or 2 years' time.
What is the main reason behind startups failing?
I think the number one reason a startup fails is because people don't like your product, or they're not prepared to pay for it at the right price, right? And not liking your product can have many aspects to it. Let's say I have a product, it's at a huge discount on my website, I buy it, but then my service is very shoddy afterwards. People say, I don't want to use this website. Food delivery, cabs, I think it's tough, because so there is a concept called liquidity, right? Liquidity means, in the case of cabs, that I have so many of them around that I can get an Ola within 3, 4, 5 minutes. Now, unless the rival startup doesn't have that kind of liquidity and has so many cabs everywhere, their cabs are going to take 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. So you'll start preferring Ola, Uber, which have so many cabs, which will get it out there, right? Similarly with the food companies, right? They just have so many restaurants that what is it additional that the new company is going to provide them? There has to be something different, something special that they can provide, which will make the customer shift, and it happens, right? So in social networking, once upon a time, we thought Facebook has got everything, because all my friends on Facebook, they're posting photos, they're writing stuff, but then you had Instagram, and then you had TikTok. So innovation, never rule out innovation in any of these areas. Oh, I think fintech.
Absolutely.
For the simple reason that India is so underbanked.
Yes.
How many credit cards do you have? How many loans have you taken? Can you pay everywhere? Have you eradicated money? And when you ask yourself those questions, the answer is mostly no. Right? So I think that applies. I made a you know, very, you're getting all kinds of interesting startups. I met a startup the other day, which is providing loans for parents for helping them pay school fees. Right? We have an investment in an amazing startup that is helping, that is providing loans to people that have hospitalization. If you think of if you think about insurance, health insurance, only 3% of the population has it. So 97% of the population, when they go to hospital, sudden surgery or pregnancy or whatever it is, and you need money, IVF treatment, XYZ, right? Where do you get that from? So if I give you a loan and I assess you're an able person and you can pay it over 12 months or 18 months, it allows you to proceed.